Tonight, I want to talk to you about what happens next. Damon Vickers is a man that I met, I don't know, about a year ago, I think. He's a managing director of Nine Points Capital Partners, and he is also the author of The Day After the Dollar Crashes, a survival guide for the rise of the New World Order. That doesn't sound happy to me. Damon is here. You line out... Hi, Damon. How are you?
Hey, good to see you again.
You line out a 15-day calendar here. China starts with, China says no more bombs. At the end, it's life as you understand it. I mean, business and money and everything else, as we understand it, is totally different. 2 weeks later. Okay, right?
Yes.
All right. America, I want you to see, Damon's actually not the unreasonable one. I had a guy who said, oh, it'll happen in 3 days. Three. You've taken a whole 15. The key is, when does it catch up to you? Now, let's start with this. China says no more bonds. Show me how, because this is the premise, this is the trigger, show me how realistic this can be in the next 12 months.
China's just starting to say no. So their opening act would be to really just say no more bonds. And they're not buyers
of
our bonds.
And this is where, when they say no more bonds, this is why Europe is going towards the austerity. They're cutting back because they have to signal to the rest of the world, okay, we're serious. We know we can't spend like this.
Right.
Right?
And it's really showing up in Europe first, and it's we're looking at the future.
Okay.
Europe is our future.
All right. Day number one, China says no more bonds. Day two, what happens on Wall Street?
Markets are spooked, a little eerie, quiet, but there's a kind of a hush all over Wall Street. It's surprising.
Okay.
Definitely Wall Street is a little surprising.
Odds that this happens in the next year?
You
have no idea.
I think very good, and I think it's it may already have happened.
Okay. The next day, day three, it's the same, but now there are rumors. What are the rumors?
The rumors are, I guess, of the instability in the markets, the instability in the bond market, and really, you know, really what's next, and that people are starting to worry about maybe a panic or anything.
President said anything at this point?
Might have gone on TV, made a speech,
okay.
That they'll find ways to continue the economy strong and sound. You know, that's typical Obama speak.
Right, seeing that it's Friday, Saturday he knows that the kids are at soccer, so...
Yeah.
Really, knowing the government, they just try to get to Friday. And everything will just magically change over the weekend.
Right.
Sunday, the Asian markets open, and what happens?
Asian markets open, and the Asian markets are in free fall. Major declines. Every crash that we've had, whether it's the 87 crash or even the instability that we saw in 08, it really opens up in Asia. Asian markets are way down.
Okay. Then our stock market, or no, our dollar is down. You say our dollar is worth, on Sunday, this started on Wednesday, on Sunday, if you had $100 in the bank, you now have $90 in the bank of value.
Right.
Correct?
Yeah.
Gold is up $200 an ounce.
Easily.
Easily.
Yeah.
Monday, the Dow opens. What happens?
Dow plunges 900, maybe 1,000 points in 20 minutes.
Markets have to close.
Markets close, yeah. It's just overwhelming. People are in shock walking around. And
you're saying the market closes in 20 minutes. Okay. Europe raises their interest rates. What does that mean?
Well, it's a scramble for liquidity. It's all about liquidity. It's all about where do you find the real liquidity globally.
Okay, so hang on just a second.
That's the problem.
So Europe raises their interest rate. That means they have debt. They need the money. So they say, we're going to give you... we're going to give you a higher yield on your bonds, right?
We're going to give you more interest.
We're going to give you more interest. If you invest in Europe, and what happens is they're sucking the money out of here. Everybody's starting to freak out about us. And so Europe tries to position themselves as a good investment. Hey, invest over here. We'll give you more if you come over here, right?
Right. You're trying to compensate the investor for the risk of making the investment. And as the markets get riskier, interest rates rise as Western economies scramble for liquidity.
Okay. Day seven, we're the first week in. Day seven, wait until you see what day 15 looks like for you next. China says no more bonds, spooked on Wall Street. Rumors are happening. Then the Asian markets start to fall. The Dow plunges. Markets close in the first 20 minutes in week one. Markets are unable to open. Emergency Fed meetings are happening. They open at 10:45. Is it over? The next day, it's all quiet. The market starts to rally. What do you mean by a rally on that day? We went through this. I mean, I could see CNBC cheering.
Oh, yeah.
The dopes just going, it's over. Invest. Now's a good time to buy, right?
You can definitely see it.
Oh, yeah. It's happening.
And, people buy dips. So the market sells off 900 points.
They say this is the bottom.
That's a chance to buy some buy.
Got it.
Downtrend.
The next day, it's stable. Then Friday, you say the dollar plunges. 10 to 15. Didn't it already plunge? Dollar already plunged, didn't it? Yeah, 10%. So now we're an additional 10 to 15%.
Yeah, the trend persists. The selling persists. And that's what surprises people as we move towards the weekend, is that the actions of the Fed, the actions of the government to quiet the markets are not working.
Okay, so we've seen this before, where, it's all fixed. And people get euphoric and they're like, hey, because they want to believe. And then it just, because it's gravity, it comes down.
Market forces are generally always stronger than the government's ability to contain them.
In your scenario, it's lucky because now it's Saturday. So the Fed has the weekend, has a Saturday where they can meet. They meet, then they raise the interest rates 5 to 6%. What does that mean?
They're trying to attract buyers. It's the scramble for global liquidity. That's what this whole game is all about. And so to entice investors to take higher levels of risk, they've got to raise interest rates. They raise interest rates again, and in the book we lay it out that there are no buyers.
Okay. And then you say day 13, lucky 13, Monday, you say it's global meltdown. You say the Dow falls 3,000 points in one day. But this is not just the Dow. This is every market. So resources are just being destroyed everywhere, right?
Well, it's the value of most global assets in the world have been driven up by leveraged and hypothecated money. So collapses in equities or collapses in real estate are really just markets finding their own value.
It's gravity. It's gravity. Okay, then the IMF and the G20 meet. There's a total restructure of all debt. This is a big day. After this happens, this is a big day because spooky dude has his new world order. Total restructure, a new global order. Explain what this is.
Well, there's a lot of debt in the world amongst Western Europe and the United States. It's massive. It's an amount of debt that can never be paid.
Never.
And so we get to the point where basically
clear all the chips off
and
say we're starting
fresh.
You've got
to clear it out. It's what happens in a bankruptcy.
And you're saying this is on global television in different languages all around the earth. We're all watching it at once. And they're saying there's a new global order, okay, right?
A new global order, a new world order.
That's when you're saying that's when the public panics all over the world, because they don't like this. And that's not just America. Nobody likes this. The banks, people start breaking into the banks. I want my money. The ATMs are now out of cash. There's nothing left. Food, it's beginning to look now like hurricane. You know, a hurricane comes and, you know, hey, there's going to be a heavy snowstorm in New England and all the food is gone off the shelves. You say, it's there. And this is where the real trouble for the public begins, right?
Correct.
Okay.